Hey everyone, and welcome back. Today I want to share with you some of my favorite multi-purpose items that I use and own as a minimalist. And I feel like items like these really are one of the secret keys to minimalism because it's one item that can be used in many ways, replacing your need to own more. So today I want to share with you 10 of my favorite multi-purpose items, what they are and how I use them. So I'm excited to dive right into this. If you haven't already though, be sure to hit that subscribe button below. And a big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. We'll talk about them in a bit, but now let's jump right in. And getting started with our first item, one of my favorite multi-purpose possessions is a smartphone. And I feel like smartphones have really kind of come under fire recently, and I know several people who've actually recently chosen to use a flip phone or a dumb phone instead of their smartphones. And I definitely understand that there are kind of dangers associated with smartphones, but that being said, they really are a fantastic multi-purpose tool that can be used to replace so many different daily items. I use my iPhone as a calculator, as a GPS, as a dictionary, as a camera, as a note-taking device, as a calendar, and the list goes on. And so while yes, it's good that we're conscious of how much time we're on our smartphones for and to be sure that we're not overusing them, they still are a really powerful tool that we can use in so many different ways in our lives. But because I do own a smartphone, it enables me not to own a clock, a GPS, I don't have a dictionary or a calendar. So there are a lot of everyday items which traditionally I may have needed to own, but because I have a smartphone, it makes it so that I don't actually have to own or possess any of those items. And just to be clear on this one, you don't need to own the latest and greatest smartphone to be able to gain all of those benefits. I think my phone is 3 years old now. Still works perfectly well and does all of those things for me. Moving on though, another multi-purpose item that I love is glass jars, which I feel like is a staple in many homes, but I love mine because I'll use it as a planter, I hold a lot of grocery staples in there, in a pinch I'll use it as a cup, I'll use it for whenever I'm watercoloring, I'll put my water in there so I can paint from it, and they're also great for organization. We use them specifically for organizing our art supplies, so we'll keep pens in one, pencils in another, paintbrushes in another, and it just makes it really easy to see everything that you have and keep it all nice and orderly. And then of course I didn't even mention it yet, but you can also use glass jars for their traditional purpose of canning goods. So this really is one of those like super useful items to own that you can just use in dozens of different ways. Okay, this is another one that many people probably have lying around the house somewhere, and that is coconut oil. And I feel like most often people use this in baking and a variety of different recipes, and often as a kind of a healthier substitute to something like vegetable oil or canola oil, but its uses are definitely not limited just to baking. I've actually been using it as an eye makeup remover for several years now, and it does a great job of removing any kind of mascara, eyeshadow, eyeliner, anything like that. Plus it's really moisturizing as well, so it's great for that more delicate eye region. And then another use that I've recently started using it for is as a cuticle oil. Especially during the winter, my hands get very dry, and so it's nice just to be able to bring a little bit of moisture in a really healthy way to that nail region. Okay, so far we've talked about a few that I'd say are fairly common household items. But this next one is definitely a specific purchase that we made that we have loved its multi-purpose function for, and that is our couch. And this couch was one of the very first things that we bought when we first moved to Charlotte, and I feel like we kind of stumbled upon it by accident, but in the 3 years since we've been living in Charlotte, it really has become probably one of my favorite purchases that we've ever made. At first glance, it isn't anything too special. It's just a basic gray couch, which looks nice, but there really isn't anything too interesting going on. But what I love about this couch is that it actually folds out into a bed, which is great for having guests over, as well as because it's so often to do, we'll often lay it out when watching a movie with friends or even just the two of us, and it gives us a really nice space to recline. And on top of that, it also lifts up on the side, so it has extra storage hidden in there as well. So what looks like a nice traditional couch actually also serves as a bed and as storage. So it really has been something that we've gotten so much use out of in the time that we've been living here. All right, and before we continue on with our list of multi-purpose items that I use and love, I want to share with you a bit about today's sponsor, Skillshare. It's an online learning community that really takes that idea of being a continual learner to the next level with thousands of classes that can help you explore your creativity or deepen your existing passions. And I've taken so many incredible classes on Skillshare, on everything from how to take care of my houseplants better, to how to grow and run an online business, to interior design and how to style my home, to essentialism, and so much more. And one of the classes I've taken recently that I absolutely loved was called Watercolor in the Woods, A Beginner's Guide to Painting the Natural World. It's taught by Rosalie Hazlett, which is such a beautiful name, but she's a nature illustrator and really does a fantastic job of helping you learn how to step by step paint the world around you. Plus, the course just gives off these majorly cozy vibes, and I am all about it. And something that I love about Skillshare is that they really do try to make learning affordable. In fact, a Skillshare premium membership is less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. So if you're interested in checking out Watercolor in the Woods or one of the thousands of other amazing classes on Skillshare, you can sign up using the link in the description box below. And for a limited time, when you use that link in the description box, you can actually get a free trial of the premium membership. So guys, I love Skillshare. I really think you guys are going to enjoy them too. So be sure to check that out. But now let's continue on with our fifth multi-purpose item, and that is a French press. And I feel like nowadays people have a million and one different contraptions to make their tea or coffee, and I'm sure a lot of them do some wonderful things. However, I love my French press because it is kind of an all-in-one device that allows me to make whatever hot beverage I want in a really easy and quick manner. And I think that most of the time when people hear the words French press, they immediately think of a coffee maker and don't necessarily think that it can be used for other things. However, as a big lover of loose leaf tea, I've discovered that it actually makes a fantastic brewer of tea because you can just put your tea leaves in at the bottom, let the tea steep, and then it really seamlessly makes it so that you're not getting any of your tea leaves into your actual tea. So I use this guy for tea, for coffee, for cold brews, but then there's also been many a time when I've used it for more creative purposes as well, like when I was making a strawberry lemonade, I used it to make sure that I wasn't getting any strawberry seeds into the lemonade as I poured it. And so it just works really well whenever you're needing a strainer as well. So it really is one of those items that just has a lot of different uses, and because of it, I don't have like an espresso maker, a coffee maker. There are a lot of like tea infusing specific teapots that you can get. Don't have one of those. I find that this thing just comes in so handy, and I honestly use it pretty much every day. Next up, we have a bit of a strange and an odd looking device that I know when I've shared it in videos in the past, people have been really confused by what it is. This is a lint brush. And you may have seen these before. They have a fabric end that does a great job of just removing any kind of fuzz that you might get on your clothing or furniture or anything like that. But this isn't any old lint brush either. On the other side of it, it actually has a depilling attachment. So I can use it to remove any pills on things like blankets, sweaters, any kind of clothing that can pill up over time. This can be a great way of removing those. And so in a lot of ways, it's kind of an all-in-one device for fabric care, which is really great because it allows me to kind of extend the useful life of a lot of the fabrics and textiles that I use on a daily basis. Plus, it keeps everything looking in good condition too, which is always a bonus. Let's talk about number 7 next, and this one is not sexy in any way, and it is about as traditional as you can get, but I couldn't really do this video on multi-purpose items without bringing it up, and that is a good old bar of soap. So specifically, this is the one that goes in my shower, and I have used a simple bar of soap to really significantly reduce the amount of products that I need when showering. So I use this simple bar of soap as a kind of combination of body wash, shower gel, and shaving cream. So it's 3-in-1 and really much cheaper than any of those other items by themselves. And as crazy as it may sound, soap is definitely nothing new. All of those products that I just mentioned are things that I used to own and use personally, and they take up a lot of space in my shower. So kind of going old school and switching back to that traditional bar of soap really did save me a lot of clutter and money. Let's move on next to number 8 though, and that is this pot. So obviously we all know that pots have literally countless options when it comes to what you can cook in them, when it comes to your stovetop. But what I love about this pot in particular is that unlike my old cookware set, which was not oven safe, this one actually serves as a Dutch oven as well, meaning that I can bake things to my heart's content in there, whether that's soups, stews, or anything like that. So that's really handy to have, and it's great too because it really frees me up to own less when it comes to my cookware, which is fantastic. Because honestly, pots and pans take up a lot of space. Plus, I'm just gonna throw this out there, but this also looks so much better than my old pot set, so it's a win-win-win. Okay, let's talk about another multi-purpose staple and one that I use personally all the time, and that is baking soda. Again, with this one, it is obviously fantastic for baking, but I feel like that's where many people stop with this one. In reality though, baking soda has so many uses. A few things that I love doing with it are using it as an air freshener for my fridge. It does a great job of removing any odors in there. I also love mixing a little bit of it into my shampoo. My mother-in-law is a hairdresser and she kind of taught me this trick, but it works as a great cleanser and helps remove any kind of product buildup from your hair. So if you use hairspray or styling creams or anything like that, it's really useful for that. And then you can use it in a lot of DIY cleaners too, and the options with it really are endless. So this guy's really small and compact, but really packs a powerful punch. So if you haven't fully explored the possibilities when it comes to baking soda, I would highly recommend it as a great, really multi-purpose and just useful item to have. And then finally, let's end this one off with number 10, and that is our PlayStation. And I'll be the first to admit that I was a bit skeptical when Christopher told me that he wanted a PlayStation. I didn't grow up with gaming systems, and I thought that it might be a bit of a waste of time and money. But when it comes to talking about multi-purpose items, I will admit my first impression was wrong on this one. It's been really useful for us, not only as a gaming device, but for us, it's also replaced our DVD player as well as our Apple TV. So those are two things that prior to our PlayStation, we actually bought and were using. But once we got the PlayStation, we discovered that we could actually do all of that in one place. So we actually probably use our PlayStation now more for non-gaming related activities than for gaming ones. I don't actually play any video games myself, but Christopher does enjoy them occasionally. But we do use it quite frequently to access our subscription services like Netflix and Amazon Prime Video. And then if we ever want to borrow a DVD from a family member or watch a movie from Redbox or something like that, we also use it as a DVD player as well. So it really has been a great multifunctional item for us and one that I was really pleasantly surprised by. So I hope this list maybe gave you some ideas or inspiration on some single products that you can use in a variety of different ways. And if you guys are interested in any of the items that I mentioned today, I'll try to link to everything that I spoke about below so that you can learn a little bit more about them. Also though, I would love to know, what are some of your favorite multi-purpose items? What is that item and what do you use it for? I find that kind of thing so interesting, so let me know below. And if you guys enjoyed this video and haven't already, I would love it if you would hit that subscribe button below for more simple and intentional living videos coming at you twice a week. And finally, don't forget to use that link in the description box below so that you can get your free trial of the Skillshare Premium membership. It's awesome, guys, and I really think you're going to love it. That's everything for today's video though, guys. Thank you all so, so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.